Welcome to According to Science. I'm Zoe Foulkes. It's hard to go long without hearing about the gut these days. It's all over the place. It's the hottest wellness trend since turmeric or athleisure. But the gut is just a part of our microbiome, the ecosystem of trillions of microorganisms living inside our body right now. One study even showed that microbial cells actually outnumber our own cells. The word comes from micro, meaning small, and biome, meaning home. In other words, our bodies are essentially houses for bacteria to live in and spread.
Ew.
Sure, it's a bit gross, but we actually depend on our microbiome, which plays an incredibly important role in our health, especially in our gut health. Though different parts of our bodies have different communities of bacteria, our gut has the most, even more than the brain, which is why scientists are increasingly treating the gut as a separate body organ. And as a lot of recent scientists has shown, our gut microbiota has been linked to disease conditions like obesity, diabetes, cardiovascular disease, allergies, and even the quality of our sleep. Not my sleep. Some researchers believe that the disruption of our microbiome is behind the rise of autoimmune diseases in developed countries because children aren't being exposed to as wide a variety of germs as they used to be. Which is to say that yes, if this theory is correct, your children should be playing in dirt more. But we should all be paying more attention to our microbiome. One of the biggest reasons we've been hearing about the gut lately is because of the research showing how it's connected to our mental health. Scientists call this the microbiome gut-brain axis, and it's also bidirectional. That means the brain influences the way our gastrointestinal system functions, which in turn affects the composition of our microbiome. And our gut microbiota plays a role in producing neuroactive compounds like serotonin and important amino acids. How strong is this connection? In one study, when gut microbiomes were taken from mice that were easygoing and placed into the guts of anxious mice, they became more easygoing. Some researchers believe that the reason our microbiome has evolved to communicate with our brain is because for our microbes to spread, they need to be social and interact with other people. Researchers in Ireland found that mice raised in sterile conditions, meaning they had no microbiome, were unable to recognize other mice, including their mouse friends. So clearly, our microbiomes are important. The lesson, take care of your microbiome. Many people take probiotics, which are products containing live bacteria of the kind found in certain kinds of yogurt. While some studies have shown health benefits, there is still no consensus. What you can also do is eat a healthy, varied diet, rich in vegetables, fiber, and whole grains, and low in sugar. You'll have trillions and trillions of bacteria fans. See you next time, bye.